The announcement of the Division Heartland, among other content in the Division universe, excited many among the Division community. Despite footage and information from the Division Heartland's closed player test leaking, I will present you with an original fan concept for the Division Heartland based on the companion novel Broken Dawn. Although there was little information other than a short article describing this new direction Ubisoft is taking, a title and an image, creators have been speculating on Heartland's design and setting. Rather than making an educated guess, I want to create a concept surrounding the story, setting and factions of the Division Heartland. The concept I'm about to present is based on the Battle of Ann Arbor from the Broken Dawn companion novel, but to an extent is fictional and not the true concept of the game. Footage and information from Heartland's closed player test has leaked online, confirming it won't be set in Ann Arbor, Michigan, but in Silver Creek. A missed opportunity, in my opinion. The developers made playtesters sign an NDA not to leak information on the technical test, but it got out nonetheless. I'm not sharing information here because I respect Red Storm Entertainment's decision, so the following is fictional. In this video, I will summarize April Kelleher's journey from Broken Dawn, provide an in-depth description of the Battle of Ann Arbor to immerse you into the setting, and discuss the story, setting, and factions that would bring the world of the Division Heartland to life. Ubisoft announced the Division Heartland as a Ubisoft original under development of Red Storm Entertainment. It is marketed as a standalone, free-to-play game that doesn't require previous experience with the series, as it will provide an all-new perspective on the universe in a new setting. The statement from Ubisoft announcing it will be a Ubisoft original means Heartland isn't based on the Tom Clancy novels and will introduce a new story. It being a standalone and free-to-play game, developed by the studio that formerly focused on player versus player modes, leads many to believe it will be either a battle royale, a sequel to Survivor, or a combination of the two. However, I'm not here to regurgitate the information dozens of so-called creators have already regurgitated. I'm here to create a concept and speculate on the location, story, and factions. The title Heartland suggests the game is set in the American Heartland, an area that includes 19 states, including Michigan. The reason this is interesting is because the story of the Division 2's companion novel, Broken Dawn, is partially set in Ann Arbor, Michigan. Broken Dawn revolves heavily around the story of the Division 2. April Keller, a former design manager and survivor of green poison, witnessed her husband's murder in front of his office in New York City. Devoted to finding the reason for her husband's death, she followed clues and puzzles from a survival guide that led her to its author, Warren Merchant. Merchant provided her with answers surrounding her husband's death. Bill, as he was called, was part of a team experimenting with a novel vaccine design, a class of design under the designation Broad Spectrum Antivirals. Certain elements within the government saw green poison as a means to power, but through the efforts of the Division, Dr. Jessica Kendall was able to prototype a vaccine for the existing strain of green poison. She managed to gather design to a surviving lab in Ann Arbor, Michigan. Having to find out if Bill died a meaningful death, April started her journey for Ann Arbor, Michigan. About 6 months after her journey, April nearly reached Ann Arbor and was joined by Ike Ronson. Unbeknownst to her, Ronson was a rogue Division agent working with Black Tusk to track down April and the broad spectrum antivirals she was after. Before reaching the Northern Campus, the location of the research lab, another Division agent caught up with them. Aurelio Diaz. Diaz was tracking Ronson for disavowing the Division as he caused the death of innocent civilians. The group reached the research center. April got her questions answered and Ronson called in the code word to Mantis, a battalion of Black Tusk operative deployed to a staging area near Ann Arbor and moved in once the presence of the antivirus was confirmed by Ronson. Black Tusk were on their way to retrieve the antivirus and extract him. Diaz, however, knocked out Ronson and told the personnel to evacuate the building. Black Tusk, at that point not known to the Division, planned to seize fuel supplies up and down the East Coast. That meant they had a large number of vehicles and, as Ronson said, mobility wins wars. In the distance, Diaz heard the low rumbling of helicopter blades. The JTF garrison was scrambling into a defensive posture. Diaz wondered why Black Tusk was attacking, but he quickly understood. Black Tusk thought the samples of the antivirus were still on site, but were unaware they were already sent to Washington, D.C. Small arms fire from the south tore into the fence and ricocheted off the Jersey barriers. Black-clad soldiers weaved among the cars as the JTF returned fire. Three Black Hawks came into view over the trees to the east. Diaz quickly calculated they were up against 50 hostiles or more with close air support. Diaz tapped his watch face and then his ear. This is Division Agent Aurelio Diaz, current location Ann Arbor near the intersection of Fuller Road and Beale Avenue. JDF position here under assault from platoon strength paramilitary force with helicopter air support. Request immediate fire support, all agents and available assets. Glass shattered behind him as stray rounds started to find the building's front walls. Two of the Blackhawks swung around the south while the third stayed behind, holding its position several hundred yards away. Diaz attempted to find the local JTF commander to ask for anti-air weapons. April stayed behind, unable to fight back or escape. JTF defenders fired back at the approaching Black Tusk soldiers. One of the two approaching helicopters reached a spot about 100 yards away and hovered there. A heavy machine gun mounted on its side door opened up, chewing through the wooden walls of the JTF positions. The second helicopter came around behind it, easing down until it hovered less than 3 feet off the ground. April saw soldiers clustered in the door, their feet hanging over the side, with others standing behind them. Finally, she saw an opportunity to do something. She rested the Super 90's barrel on the Jersey barrier and braced herself. As the chopper's skids touched the ground, April unloaded its full magazine, 8 loads of buckshots at the open door. The helicopter was 50 yards away, so there was a lot of scatter in the loads. She saw some of the black uniformed soldiers drop to the ground. Others dodged away from the door as sparks flew from the Black Hawk's fuselage. Unfortunately, her fire drew the attention of the other helicopter. Its machine gun swung in her direction, bullets hammered into the concrete, stinging her with flying shards, but the chopper couldn't quite get the angle on her. It wouldn't be long though. When the machine gun's fire swept onto another target, April scrambled on her feet and ran around the west side of the building, pinning herself to the wall just past the corner. From the roof just over her head, she heard rifle fire. Impact stars bloomed all over the windshield of the closest helicopter. Other JTF soldiers concentrated fire on the same helicopter and eventually it heeled over and took a position farther away to the southeast. Now its machine guns raked the front of the building, turning the two-story windows into a waterfall of glass shards. Shooting around the gate intensified and something exploded under one of the JTF firing platforms. A moment later, 4 of the black uniformed soldiers got through the gate. JTF defenders cut them down, but the helicopter opened up on them. Seconds later, another group came through. This time they got halfway through the building entrance before Diaz popped up and shot 3 of them. The other one returned fire, but Diaz was off and running, weaving past generators and stacks of crates. The third helicopter had been out of her field of vision for a while, but now it loomed directly over April's head. It hovered over the lab building, its downdraft beating on April as it unloaded its complement of soldiers onto the building's roof. Diaz came hustling around the far corner, staying close to the wall. Halfway to April, he stopped and raised his rifle. Instinctively, she hit the ground and Diaz fired over her. She rolled back to her feet to see one of the soldiers in black pitching forward face first into the grass. When he got to her, Diaz leaned in close. "They've got men on the roof. It's game over. We have to get out." He tapped his ear. "Shade Agent Diaz here. Position overrun. Urgently need tactical support. I am extracting a valuable human asset." Into the woods, April and Diaz were followed, but after taking out a couple of pursuers, the pair managed to escape. Set in Ann Arbor, the Division Heartland's location is a big college town plastered with signs directing visitors and students to the various campus locations. The Huron River divides the city into up and downtown. The North Campus, located uptown, is home to most of the university's engineering labs, including the biomedical research building that will come under attack of Black Tusk. The town was scattered with small JTF bases, stately old houses, and repurposed fraternities. Although the Midwest wasn't hit nearly as hard as the big cities like New York, Ann Arbor had seen rough times as many of the fraternity houses had burned and the strip of bars and restaurants along the south edge of the main campus showed bullet holes and broken windows. Ahead of the campus, the University of Michigan Hospital would be bordered by JTF checkpoints, and on the south side of the city, the JTF base in the football stadium could act as a base of operations. Heartland would introduce new and returning factions. First off, the Jackals, or Jamestown Aryans as they are called in the novel, are a group of criminal opportunists similar to the Hyenas or Rikers. On her journey to Ann Arbor when she was almost in town, April was ambushed by a group of 6 jackals. April ran but noticed one of her pursuers had an AR-15, seemingly looted from the local police station. It was clear the jackals didn't want to kill her and she remembered what a sailor back in Buffalo had said about the Jamestown Aryans. You'll end up married. Their motivation is most likely similar to that of the Rikers and Hyenas, survival of the fittest and living like kings. A second faction, not mentioned in a novel but one I created on concept art, are the Sons of Liberty, a Midwestern patriotic civilian militia using the pandemic as an excuse to enforce their beliefs onto the local populace. Opposing the federal government and abusing their power, these gun-toting small-towners are no better than the jackals. Their weaponry consists of civilian arms such as AR-15 shotguns and hunting rifles. Besides ex-prisoners and a civilian militia, a third faction that could be introduced are the Serpents, or something with a name a little more unique. These religious zealots created a cult-like following with the belief that green poison was the devil's work. Being supporters of Satan himself, these cultists would go around dressed in crimson robes and increase the spread of the virus across the town's population, in a sense similar to the outcasts. Concluding the factions is Black Tusk. As described in the Battle of Ann Arbor, Black Tusk was stationed near Ann Arbor with the intention to assault the North Campus and secure samples of the broad-spectrum antivirals. I don't have to go into their backstory, archetypes, or motivations because we already know those. I love to attempt to create a concept for the game in the Division universe. Fantasizing and speculating on the story, setting, factions, characters, and more allows me to expand the universe, even though it's non-canon. What would you like to see in the Division Heartland? Let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching. If you enjoy the content I create and want to support me, I would kindly ask you to like or dislike the video, leave a comment with your thoughts, and subscribe to stay up to date on the video content I create. Those interested in going the extra mile can join the channel and become a member for $1, $2, $5, or $10. Other than badges and emojis, and a thank you at the end of every video, members will have early access to uploads of short films, extended lore and documentaries, in addition to team packs for games like The Division. For more information, check the iCard in the top right corner. With that, I want to thank We Are Ninja, Sean Isom, Jack Bonny, Sal Martinez, Karsten Block, V Sparky, Nervous Wrecked, Khalil Cheeks, and Nathaniel Stevenson for being Tier 1 members. Thanks again for watching. Peace out.